This video will look at the duals of the uniform polyhedra. We have in fact already seen many of these, the bipyramids, trapezohedra and Catalan solids, as well as the regular polyhedra, which are dual to each other. That leaves these fascinating duals of concave uniform polyhedra to explore. There is a standard way of creating dual polyhedra, known as spherical inversion. Given a uniform polyhedron, such as this cube octahedron, first draw a sphere around it, then shrink the sphere slightly so it just touches every edge. Now draw tangents to the sphere, perpendicular to the polyhedron's edges. These will become the edges of the dual polyhedron. Extend these tangents until they meet above each face, forming the dual vertices. Finally, fill in the faces to create the dual polyhedron. Some of the uniform polyhedra have faces that pass through the centre of the polyhedron. These are known as hemi-polyhedra. If we attempt to find the dual to any of these, such as this tetrahemihexahedron, which has three square faces passing through its centre, the perpendicular lines to the edges round these faces will be parallel, so they never intersect, and the dual vertex cannot be found. This means that the 10 uniform hemipolyhedra have no dual, and neither does Skilling's figure. However, there are some creative ways of finding duals of hemipolyhedra, which I will discuss in a later video, but strictly speaking, duals of hemipolyhedra do not exist. We'll start with this relatively straightforward uniform polyhedron, the great cubic-cube octahedron. Here's its vertex figure. If we draw a circle around the vertex figure, representing the inverting sphere, and draw tangents, we derive the dual face, which is this kite shape. Put 24 of these kites together, one for each vertex, and we get the dual figure, the great hexachronic icositetrahedron. Highlighting a single face, we can see that it's partially hidden inside the dual. In fact, two of the corners of the kite are hidden, which means that the dual has hidden vertices. If we remove the faces surrounding one of the outside four vertices, one of the hidden vertices is revealed. It's a vertex surrounded by eight faces, so it must be the dual vertex to an octogrammic face of the original polyhedron. The original can be combined with the dual to make an interesting compound. The next two are the small cubic-cube octahedron and the small rhombihexahedron. Again, we can derive the dual faces from the vertex figures and assemble the duals. Surprisingly, these two, the small hexachronic icositetrahedron and the small rhombihexachron, appear identical. The only differences are in the internal structure, which can be seen in wireframe models with only one face displayed. The faces of the left-hand figure extend into the figure, but on the right-hand side, they are wholly external. Also, the vertex arrangements of the two figures are different. There are three more pairs of uniform duals that are outwardly identical. These two, the small dodecachronic hexecontahedron and the small rhombi-dodecachron. Then the small ditrigonal dodecachronic hexecontahedron and small dodecacosacron. And finally, the great deltoidal hexecontahedron and great rhombi-dodecachron. Duals of more complicated snub polyhedra tend to be equally complicated. This medial pentagonal hexecontahedron is the dual of the snub dodecadodecahedron. It has 60 irregular pentagonal faces. A closer look reveals several small facets on the surface, where vertices and edges come close to each other but don't quite meet. great deltoidal icositetrahedron has dart-shaped faces that pass through the body of the figure and out the other side, so that all vertices are visible. The great ditrigonal dodecachronic hexecontahedron has a somewhat comical appearance, like a crumpled icosahedron. The great dodecaicosacron has faces that are crossed quadrilaterals, or bowtie shapes. The inverted snub dodecadodecahedron has faces passing very close to the centre, so its dual, the medial inverted pentagonal hexecontahedron, has some vertices very far from the centre, resulting in an exceptionally spiky polyhedron. The dual faces are long, thin pentagons, with an acute angle under 4 degrees, and longest sides 70 times as long as the shortest sides. Only the 12 sharp vertices are visible within the dual. 72 other vertices are hidden inside. The great pentakis dodecahedron is also very spiky. It has 60 highly acute isosceles triangles, bases hidden within the figure. Other contenders in the spiky states are the great distiaches triacontahedron and the great pentagrammic hexecontahedron, which has more spikes than most. Duals with octahedral symmetry tend to be less pointy, but the tetradiaches hexahedron has 6 sharp points, and the great triaches octahedron has 8. The dual of the small ditrigonal icosidodecahedron is the small triambic icosahedron. This has 20 faces in the same planes as the platonic icosahedron, and it can be viewed as an icosahedron with its faces extended until they meet again with other faces. Such polyhedra are called stellations. I plan to cover these in a lot more detail in future videos. There are 2 other uniform duals that are icosahedron stellations, the medial triambic icosahedron and the great triambic icosahedron. These are another pair that are externally identical. The small stellar pentakis dodecahedron has 12 relatively blunt vertices on the outside. The medial deltoidal hexecontahedron has all vertices visible to the outside, a mixture of 4 and 5-fold vertices. The medial icosachronic hexecontahedron has alternating 5-fold and 6-fold vertices. The tridiaches icosahedron has prominent 10-fold vertices, with small 6-fold vertices nestling between them. The medial hexagonal hexecontahedron, being the dual of a chiral snub polyhedron, has unusually shaped faces and an intriguing twisted appearance. Although the great truncated cube octahedron has octogrammic faces, with density 3, the corresponding vertices in its dual have density 1. The great distiaches dodecahedron is one of only a few concave uniform duals that has no hidden structure. All its faces are completely visible to the outside. The great rhombihexachron's faces are also completely visible, and the same applies to the rhombicosachron. The medial rhombic triacontahedron and great rhombic triacontahedron are closely related. They both have 30 rhombic faces, and they are topologically the same. There is a third related dual, the rhombic triacontahedron, a Catalan solid dual to the icosidodecahedron. The great icosachronic hexecontahedron has dart-shaped faces. Its appearance is dominated by 20 hexagonal vertices, with 12 pentagonal vertices sprouting between them. The medial distiaches triacontahedron is a striking shape with 12 decagonal pyramids. The great dodecachronic hexecontahedron is a rough-looking shape with prominent decagrammic vertices. The small hexagonal hexecontahedron is the dual of the small snub icosicosidodecahedron, which has coplanar faces. Consequently, it has double vertices, points where two topologically distinct vertices coincide. These are the vertices that look like hexagonal vertices, but they are actually two triangular vertices at the same point. Concentrating on this green vertex, we can colour one set of surrounding faces blue and the other set red. Although the red faces intersect the blue faces, they do not share an edge. The great stellar Pentaces dodecahedron has 20 visible hexagonal vertices and 12 hidden pentagrammic vertices. The small icosachronic hexecontahedron is a relatively spherical shape, as the faces don't penetrate far into the interior. There are only a few more duals to describe, all of them duals of the more complex snubs. The great hexagonal hexecontahedron is another figure with double vertices, but in this case they are not visible externally. The great triacontahedron icosahedron has prominent decagrammic pyramids. Around the base of each pyramid, tiny slivers of faces are just visible. The great inverted pentagonal hexecontahedron has a few minute parts of faces visible at the bottom of its valleys. The great pentagonal hexecontahedron is another highly complicated jewel with a confusing jumble of faces and edges. Each face is separated into 11 visible sections. And finally, the small hexagrammic hexecontahedron is possibly the most complicated of all the uniform jewels. Its faces look like pentagrams, but are actually irregular crossed hexagons. These intersect each other in wildly complex ways. There are 100 visible vertices, where three faces meet, but 40 of them coincide in pairs. These are the hexagrammic vertices. There are also 12 pentagrammic vertices hidden inside the figure. As always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.